Hello explorers and welcome to another video. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about Polymer 3 and lit HTML and how to merge these two technologies together. And you might think this is a little bit of a weird merge, but it actually isn't, because the Polymer team is actually the ones who have implemented lit HTML. And if not, the templating language inside of Polymer 3 will take off, then they might replace it with lit HTML, because that's a technology that they are really pushing for. So either the HTML, lit HTML will be used in Polymer 3, or they might be taking some part of that technology into Polymer 3. So I actually got a question about this today, just as I was about to prepare for this video. I got a question about how to do this exact thing, so it's really timely that I put this video together. And when you're building a Polymer app, you have a templating language already. So let's start by looking at Polymer 3 app. And to do that, you first will look at this package.json. And as Polymer 3 is so new, they haven't actually built it into the Polymer CLI toolkit yet. That will be something that they will add further down the line. So for now, you use yarn to install your packages. So you initialize your yarn project. You add flat to the package.json, and that will make a flat structure, so you don't have anything that is bundled within anything else, and that makes the links between the different packages easier. And then we have some dependencies here. So I have the lit element. We will look at that. And then we have Polymer 3 pre. We have some web components, JS for some older versions of the different browsers. And then we have the lit HTML package. So those are the dependencies we need for this project. So if we look at the HTML here, it's just importing some modules and then using the elements. So let's jump into a Polymer 3 element. And that starts by importing the Polymer element from the Polymer library. And then you extend your element with the Polymer element. You set up a little template. And in my constructor here, I actually set the name property to 3 previews. So that was what you saw in the display earlier. This is my 3.0 preview app. And then I have a static property down here, and I defined my custom element in this list down here. So that's everything you need to do in order to set up a Polymer 3 element. And as you see, it's using the JS modules, and it uses ES syntax and so on, ES6 syntax. So it's quite a new technology, but as browsers evolve, it will be become standard in the browsers. And you use the Polymer CLI to host your different packages. The only thing you need to remember when you start this is that you serve it with --npm in order for it to find all dependencies. And then we look into the lit HTML here. It's not that different. We import the lit element and HTML. So this is the HTML tag that we use in the template. We saw that earlier in the video about lit HTML. So if you want to learn more about lit HTML, I have a video for that. And if you want to learn more about Polymer, I have a video about that as well. So this lit HTML element, it extends the lit HTML lit element, and this is actually Google Labs or a Polymer Labs element. So it's not in something that you should use in production at the moment. It's something that they are playing around with, but it might become something standard in the future. So I set up a property. I have my constructor again here. I set the name Explorers, and then I just render it with the hello name from lit HTML lit element, and then I export it as usual. So this example is very similar to the other element that you saw earlier. But if you do this, you might run into a little bit of a problem because it's still very much in beta and it's still very much a lab element. In my setup here, I actually had to go into the lit HTML, lit element package here and then look at the lit element JS. And in here, everything was set to import from at Polymer and so on. And I had to add the relative URL to actually find the different parts in here in order to run it when I served it. So if you want to try this out yourself, you just have to clone this repository, yarn setup, and then you need to yarn install, I guess, and then use this little trick to get your Polymer lit element to work, and you can try it out yourself. I think this is really fun and really interesting that it's so easy to use different templating libraries in your elements at the moment. And I think as the different technologies evolve, they will actually standardize on something that is really nice and that should bring the web really forward in this regard. Because when you have a templating language that is really powerful, written in Java, and you can get some speed and performance behind it, you can really make something, some interesting applications from this. So far, we are still very much in the early stages of this. The pre-release of Polymer 3 was announced at the last Polymer Summit that I attended, and I'm really looking forward to the next summit where they might be a little bit more forward and perhaps they actually have something that they can release by then. But it's still in active development, so maybe you should stay with Polymer 2 at the moment, and perhaps you can use some of these techniques there as well. I hope that you found this video interesting. I hope that you learned something today. And if you like this video, give it a like, share it with your friends and colleagues. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. And I really hope to see you